The history of Rangers FC is full of staggering statistics. 54 league titles, 60 domestic cups, one European Cup Winners' Cup, 134 million quid in unpaid tax. Here's how this famous old club created a financial model for comedians all over Britain to follow. Her Majesty's Revenue and Customs confirmed they're investigating Rangers over payments made over the past decade to pricey superstars. Scottish businessman Craig White buys the club from Sir David Murray for a quid and immediately tells the fans the HMRC case is nothing to worry about. Fierce rival Celtic are pipped by a point for Rangers' 54th domestic title. The club gets a final warning over an unpaid £2.8 million bill. More revelations, this time that White borrowed money against the future sale of season tickets worth £24 million to help fund his buyout. White admits the unpaid tax bill could be as much as £75 million, including the £9 million he's clocked up in 10 months, and says they can't pay.
It will have incredible impact in Scottish football. Not for the good, for everybody, that is without doubt.
Rangers is placed into administration, docked 10 points by the SFA and put up for sale.
Well, I've been a fan for 34 years and my dad took me to the Rangers games, my first breath, took me to the Rangers games. I'm really crying as it is, and it's destroyed my world today, really.
The owner is declared unfit to hold a position in football and the club is charged with bringing the game into disrepute. Redundancies are announced and players' salaries are cut. Rangers are banned from signing players for 12 months and fined 160 grand. White is banned for life and fined 200 grand. HMRC reject a final bid. The club's 140-year history effectively ends in liquidation. But former Sheffield United chief exec Charles Green buys the rights to set up a new version. SPL clubs will vote on the 4th of July to decide whether this new co should be readmitted to the top league. It would need an 8-4 majority, but six clubs have already announced they'll vote no. The new Rangers will therefore have to apply to play in the lower leagues, but several players have already objected to their contracts being transferred to the new setup and walked away. No club and no team either.
I'd like to think that there's a team there for the 50,000 that turn up every 2 weeks, and all these people need a team to support, and hopefully at the end of this, there is a team there.